Oh, Ismene, my dearest sister, she never did listen to me, not once ever, always wanting to do what I do, although seeming to teeter on the cusp of common sense, moreover leaning towards the side of her best interests. Ismene's greatest weakness was always being our father.
Let us begin, oblivion of the past, memories of the way war beguiling into somber sound.
Him too. Was just a friend before his native land. I price nothing.
A charge of the first soul.
Of the body? Sentries are set already.
Then what else is there besides what you pay on us?
Not to connive in disobedience.
There's no such fool to embrace his death.
Death is a penalty. Men right often are brought to ruin through their dreams of gain.
Well, I'm telling you, the body somebody has just now buried, sprinkled of thirsty dust over the forehead of the prophets, has gone off.
What say you? What man dare it?
I will not. None must throw the messenger who brings more news.
Zeus, your speech, before I choke.
Heaven may be praised. I wish I was in safety. This is the woman who has done the deed.
What is it? You seize her and bring her? In what way and whence?
Burying that man herself, you know the whole.
Are you earnest? Do you understand what you're saying?
Yes, I saw the girl burying the body you forbade to bury. Do I speak clear and plain?
I say I did it. I deny it not. And what are you gonna do about it? She spoke the truth. She was earnest. I buried my brother who deserved it. He needs to be buried as he lived, honorably.
Because it was not Zeus who ordered it, nor justice tolerant of the men of gods gave law to such men, nor did I deem your ordinance of so much binding force, as that a mortal man can overbear the unchangeable, unwritten code of heaven. This is not today and yesterday, but lives forever, having origin whence no man knows. Foolish, 'tis like I'm found guilty of folly out of fool's mouth.
You, of all people, are singular in your discernment.
Nay, they too discern, but they refrain their tongues at your behests.
Are you not ashamed that you deem otherwise?
So yes, I deem otherwise, for who in their godforsaken mind would ever listen to anything Creon says in his power-hungry tirades?
An enemy will never be a friend, even in death.
Well, I was made for fellowship and love, not for fellowship and hate.
Then get you down hither and love, if you must love, the dead. No woman, while I live, shall order me.
So then he sent me to death.
Never shall she live on to marry me.
Die as she may, she shall not die alone.
Art thou grown bold enough to threaten too?
Oh, dearest Haman, how you are slighted by your father. He needn't do this. Behold me, people of my native land, I win my latest way. I gaze upon the latest light of day, that I shall never see. Death, who lays all to rest, is leading me to Alterin's far strand.
Alive! Not death-stricken yet!
Thou shalt not tread upon my wits, be sure.
Unhallowed, disappointed, uninterred, wherefore delayed avenging punishers, furies from death and heaven, lay awake for thee. To take thee in the evil of thine own hands, look to it whether I be bribed to speak, for as to that with no great wear of time. Men's, woman's wills to thine own house shall answer, also all cities right in enmity. And learn to keep a tongue more gentle, and a brain more sober than he carries now.
Thank you.
Go set free the maiden from the vault and build a tomb for the outcast.
You prove it? You deem that I should yield?
Sir, with all my speed, swift footed calm calamities from heaven to cut off the preserve.
O God, 'tis hard, but I quit at heart and yield. I cannot fight at odds with destiny.
Upon them to work, commit it to others.
I am gone.
He is no more. Slap but split in my own stranger's hand.
By her, collapsing her about the waist, mourning his wedlock severed in the grave, and his sire's deeds and his ill-fated bride. He, when he sees them, with a terrible cry, goes in towards him, calling out loud, "Ah, miserable, what hast thou done? What mine hast thou? By what misfortune art thou crazed? Come out, my son, supplying, I asked of thee." But with fierce aspect, the youth glared at him, spat in his face, answered him not a word, grasped at the crossed fields of his sword and drew it, and for the father started forth in flight, missed him, then angered himself, poor fool. There, as he stared, he flung himself along upon the sword point firmly planted in the middle of his breast, and cautious yet, clings to the maid, claps in his failing arms, and gasping, sends forth on a pallid cheek, fast feeling droops of blood. So lies he, dead, his arms round the dead, there in the grave. His bridal right is full, his misery is witness to mankind. What worst of woe? The lack of counsel brings a man to know.
Director, are you all right?
Okay.
I want to sing. Came calamities for heaven to come off the preserve.
Oh God, 'tis hard, but I will quit heart and yield. You cannot fight at odds with destiny.
Upon them to work, commit it not to others.
I am gone.